tongue is green!
What? I know I wasn't feeling good. Quick, somebody call 911. I've got to go to the hospital. Just help me! Don't just stand there. Help me!
Oh, come on, Sydney. Calm down. I'm talking about Envy.
There's no time to talk about Envy right now, whoever she is. I'm turning green, you said.
Envy's not a person. Envy is another word for jealousy. It's when you want something that somebody else has. Calm down. Your skin's not really turning green.
Oh, then where's the monster that bit me? Look at me back.
There's no monster, Sydney. It's just an expression. People call jealousy the green-eyed monster.
Well, then why did you scare me like that?
Because you need sugar. Didn't you get a bike last year for Christmas?
Yeah.
Well, what's the big deal? Is there something wrong with your bike?
No, it's just that Travis is cooler. He's got brand new styles with the cool grips and stuff. Mine is so, well, last year's model.
Well, you're lucky you got one last Christmas. I haven't got one for years. But I still get around on my bike, okay? And some kids, they don't even have bikes, Sydney. We need to be happy with what we have, knowing God will supply all our needs.
I guess you're right. I guess I have been acting a little silly. I don't need the newest bike in town, I guess.
That's right. We just have to have things like food to survive, a house, things like that. Other things are, well, we gotta get our priorities straight. What's our needs and what's our wants?
Yeah, I guess you're right. I do need all of that stuff.
Yeah, you wanna go ride bikes?
Sure.
Come on, watch out for the monster.
I'm gonna get you.
No, you're not.
Has anybody here got bit by the green-eyed monster? Yeah, they got a new bike and I didn't get a new bike. They got new shoes and I didn't get new shoes. Oh, whatever said, and be what? Content with such things as ye have. Are y'all ready to play a game?
Well, the metal part can aim better.
Ah! made off of.
Tree of wall.
Good job!
Put on the head, on the metal part you can aim better. Take one for the girls.
Died on the cross
Dad asked me to take out the trash, Kevin would say, "Aw, just a minute." It didn't matter if Mother asked him to clean up his room, Kevin would say, "Aw, just a minute." Even if they were going someplace fun, like the park or the zoo, if Mother told Kevin to get ready, he would say, "Aw, just a minute." Kevin was such a good boy, but he just had trouble obeying and coming when he was told, "Kevin, it's time for lunch," Mother said again a couple weeks later. Kevin knew he was supposed to come immediately, but he said again, "Aw, just a minute." When Kevin came in the kitchen door, there was mud all over Kevin's feet. And Mother had just got finished mopping her kitchen floor. And who was right behind Kevin? The puppy dog. The puppy dog was not supposed to come inside with Kevin. There comes Kevin, late and with muddy feet. And with the puppy dog.
"Now, Kevin, I've told you that you must come when I ask you to. Now your chicken noodle soup and your grilled cheese is cold. And look at this floor. I'm going to have to mop all over again."
Kevin's heart came out to help Kevin down from the tree, he had big tears coming down his cheeks.
Mama! Mama, why didn't you stop when I asked you to? Now I can't get a double dish on the ice cream.
Kevin was so upset. Mother didn't come immediately, and now we missed the ice cream truck. She helped Kevin down, and Mother said,
Kevin, was that nice to have to wait?
Kevin shook his head no.
No, Mama. Is that how you feel when I tell you to just a minute?
I'm hungry. Yes, Kevin. That's exactly how we feel when you don't listen.
I'm sorry, Mama. That makes me feel awful to have to wait and miss my ice cream.
Yes, Kevin, it does.
So Kevin knelt down in the yard, and with Mama, he asked Jesus to please forgive him for not obeying immediately when he was told, and always saying, "Aw, just a minute." That day, Kevin learned to obey. So what are we not gonna say when we're called? Aw, just a minute. Right, we're gonna obey immediately. How many of you have your thinking caps on? Got your thinking caps together? All right, well, Inspector Clueless is gonna come give us three clues, okay? Don't yell it out until we read all three clues, and I'll say one, two, three, and you can answer, all right? All right, let's see if it's... Yep. different shades. You just took them off. And right there, you can count now. All right. Here. Here. Right here. Just stand up when we sing. How many of you are perfect? How many never does anything wrong? No.
All right, I want you to look at this. And I want you to read.
off. Maybe you need to try one of these right here.
They work better.
Yeah, they work.
Coveting,